Hi everyone, and welcome to another Wise Money Tools video. Glad you could join me today. Maybe you're on the podcast driving. Glad to have you as well. So we're going to talk about trade wars. I mean, this has been a big deal. It's dropped the stock market. Today is the 5th of August, and we've had a 1,700 point drop in the last week or so. So there's a lot of people scared, wondering what these trade wars with China are going to do. Basically, what happened was Trump said that if you guys don't start playing by the rules, we're going to increase our trade tariffs on you by 10% come September 1st on our agriculture. It was like $300 billion worth of goods. And so rather than China backing down, they played hardball. And they said, okay, well, then we're going to quit buying so much goods. And then they really played the quote-unquote Trump card, and they devalued their currency. Now, from a world global kind of working together perspective, they weren't supposed to do that. In fact, the Feds should be all over them for doing that. So should all the other countries. Because when they devalue their currency, what happens is first off, if you're in China and now you want to go buy American goods or really goods from anywhere in the world, your currency's just been devalued. So now it costs you more to buy goods from other countries. Now that can be good if you're in China, because it's going to persuade you, if you will, to buy more Chinese goods. What it does to Americans is it, with that devalued currency, now we literally can go in and buy more goods from China, cost us less money. The question is, will we do that? And that's where this whole trade war is going to take us. Is who's going to flinch first? Who's going to back down first? Now, I'm not trying to say trade wars are good or bad or indifferent, but I kind of get the idea. We've been kind of kicked around, pushed around in our country and the trade imbalances with many countries for decades. And it is kind of nice to see that we're finally standing up for ourselves and saying, hey, you know what, this just isn't fair. It's not fair to our manufacturers. It's not fair to those who like to import and export goods. So let's get more on an equal playing field. Not to mention, China does a really good job of stealing our intellectual property and taking advantage of patents and so forth over in their country that are theoretically internationally patented. So there's some reasoning behind trying to get this all back on good footing. However, in the meantime, it can sure cause some turmoil. We've talked about this before. The stock market loves predictability, reliability, and anytime there's any kind of a shakeup, yeah, the jitters go through, and you can see what happens. I mean, just even today, part of that 1,700 point decline today was over 700 just in and of itself. So the markets do not like it when they can't predict what the future is going to look like, and we can't right now. We do know that agriculture is going to get hurt to some extent because China's going to back off buying some of our agricultural products. And again, with the devalued currency as they devalued their currency, it's going to affect our import export as well. So it's interesting. I don't know how it's all going to turn out. But one question that was asked to me from a really good friend is this the time to buy a house or wait for houses? This person was told that housing was going to drop dramatically because of the trade war. I don't see that correlation, because most of the materials that we use to build houses are American. They're here. We don't import a lot of stuff, especially from China when it comes to building houses. It's really not going to affect land prices much. So I don't see that as a big issue, but they were really concerned, hey, if I buy a house, or should I wait for housing to take a massive correction? That's probably not something that we have to worry about to this point. But we do have to worry about technology, computers, those kinds of things, because that could definitely be affected by these trade wars. So just a little update. Not sure where this is going to go. Not sure who's going to flinch first. I do hope that sooner or later, cooler heads prevail and we get back on a fair trade and a balanced system throughout the country. That can be good for everybody, both in China, America, anywhere else that we import and export goods. All right, that's about it. If you have any questions, shoot them to questions@wisemoneytools.com. Be happy to answer them as quick as I can. If you have any comments or thoughts, have some ideas on how this might turn out, feel free to express those as well below. And until next week, talk to you soon. Take care.